You may not come from the most well-to-do financial background. You may not come from the most affluent social background. If you're willing to work hard, sacrifice, and struggle, then I proclaim today, you're better than enough.
Dr. Ronald Lee McNair is the essence of being college and career ready. He was college and career ready long before it even became our mission. You take a young man from a very small town with a big dream, and he does all that it takes in order to achieve his every goal. We want every student at Main Street to have the same tenacity, to know that if they can believe it, then they really can achieve it. And we believe that Dr. Ronald Lee McNair is the epitome of the Strive Hard motto, which we say every day at Main Street. And it reads, whatever you do, strive to do it so well that no man living, no man dead, and no man yet to be born could do it any better.
Who's Ronald McNair?
Ronald McNair.
McNair.
Who's Ronald McNair?
Well, who is Ronald McNair?
A man from South Carolina.
Lake City, that is. Hey, hey, hey.
A man who came from nothing
and became something.
We often know Ronald McNair to be the second Black American to go to space.
But we never take time to think about his educational and career pathway.
Did you know this man graduated from Copper High School?
And valedictory.
By doing well academically and in sports, he prepared a great pathway for music.
He got a scholarship to go for music and sports.
Man, which one did this boy choose? Because he could play Zach and clarinet real good.
Don't forget, he used to play basketball and baseball.
And he had one track too.
McNair chose music, one of his first loves.
He attended North Carolina A&T University.
At HBCU, you know?
After attending North Carolina A&T, he began to explore his pathway.
He changed his major to physics.
He created another pathway for himself.
Yeah, he created an athletic pathway.
And yeah, he created an academic pathway for himself.
And he created a fitness pathway.
Whoa!
After graduating in 1971, he went to MIT.
He went to get his doctorate in physics.
He was extending his pathway.
Did y'all know his research was stolen while he was there?
Are you crazy?
No, I don't like that.
The same data that took 2 years to research,
he was able to reproduce it in 1 year.
In 1976, Ronald McNair became Dr. Ronald McNair.
No matter how hard things got,
or when things seemed impossible,
McNair kept going down his pathway.
After graduating, he became known as an expert.
He worked well with chemicals and labor.
He learned that one of the best labs in the world.
In 1978, McNair became one of 35 applicants chosen out of over 10,000 to become a part of NASA's astronaut program.
Now his life lights the pathway for you and me.
From his humble beginnings in the tobacco fields of Lake City, South Carolina, all the way to NASA, Dr. Ronald E. McNair lived a life full of examples for our students today. They see that it's not always how you start the race, but how you go through it and how you finish it strong. They see that someone from little old Lake City can leave a lasting mark on history, the world, and hearts. Thank you, Dr. McNair, for inspiring us to find our own personal pathways and to become just like you.
A saxophone player like Dr. Ronald E. McNair.
Whoa!
Hey!
A black belt like Dr. Ronnie McNair.
listen, gather round. I found something.
A football player like Dr. Ronald E. McNair.
Valerie McTory and Light McNair.
Wait a minute, hold on.
One of them
gotta
be salutatory because not all of us can be number one.
No, I'm number one. I'm number one.
Defy gravity like Dr. Ronald McNair. What's up, master? Hit me up. Call me. What's up?
A leader. A hero. One of the finest. Thank you for your legacy, Dr. Ronald E. McNair.
Get up and fight because you're good enough.